Hi, everybody. We've talked about diversification before when I mentioned some of the complementing services I've been offering my clients besides strict translations in my main fields of expertise. These other tasks started to pick up, especially after my main client decided to fire everyone in their own translation department and send all their translation requests to a large translation agency. I sought more clients that needed these additional services, thus diversifying my activities during my work week. Well, today, I wanted to talk about different kinds of editing tasks you can perform to diversify the language services you already offer. First of all, it's important that you talk to your clients and ask exactly what they need from you, so you're both on the same page before the project starts. Otherwise, you may end up doing more than is required or completely fall short of their expectations. The main kind of editing project a client may ask you to complete is going through the feedback that a third party provided on your own services. So let's say you've translated something and your client sent your work to one of the reviewers. You need to go through the suggestions, which hopefully were provided in Word with the track changes option turned on. That way, you only need to approve or reject each suggestion to send the final version of the document to your client. I usually work on this kind of review free of charge, considering that I've already worked on the translation myself. However, there are times when clients may have someone in the office who says they're bilingual and decided to clean up your translation. These are the times when inexperienced reviewers end up creating more work for you. So you have to be very clear with the client and let them know that this is an extra step in the process that had not been originally accounted for. One thing is for you to work with a peer who is copy editing your translation and providing honest feedback in order to improve it. Maybe correcting a typo or turning a sentence around to make it easier to read. Another thing entirely is when you have someone inexperienced trying their hand at reviewing and making a mess of a perfectly good translation. Sometimes even introducing some mistakes and mistranslations with false friends. Whenever I get this kind of review request, which usually is not provided with the changes clearly identified, I create a table in Word with a few columns to offer clients a better overview of what actually happened. In the first column, I add the original sentence or expression in the source language. In the second column, I add my translation in the target language. The third column is for the suggestions made by the reviewer. The fourth column is where my final comments go. I either thank the reviewer for catching a typo or offering a great idea, or I justify my original choice and explain why the reviewer's suggestions are actually incorrect. Having a table like this really helps clients who have no idea how the process works. And upon seeing so many changes from an inexperienced reviewer, they may think that you actually did a bad job on the translation. This is also how you point out that someone was a little too eager to show their knowledge in the source and target languages, and without any hands-on translation experience whatsoever, ended up making things worse. Well, that's actually the worst case scenario, and it has only happened to me a couple of times in quite a few years. My clients usually work with professional reviewers who provide corrections and suggestions in Word that I can clearly see and approve or reject accordingly. There are many times when I have direct contact with my reviewer and sometimes even review their work. That kind of interaction is very rewarding and can only improve the final quality of a translation, making for a successful collaboration. Now let's forget about translations for a second. Let's say you didn't translate anything and you aren't checking someone's feedback on your translation. What are the other two scenarios you could find yourself in when reviewing texts? One of them is working as a copy editor. These are usually requests for when there's no source or target document. They may be articles that someone wrote in their second language, so they want to make sure that it flows naturally. And they'll hire you as a copy editor to clean up the final copy and make sure everything is suitable to print or distribution. As a copy editor, you won't have to contrast two languages, but actually follow all the rules in the language that the text was written in and ensure that it communicates the main message clearly. Let's say copy editors are critical readers, the last set of eyes that will go through a text and make sure it fulfills its purpose. So as a copy editor, you'll be correcting typos, grammar mistakes, awkward styles, and having a final copy that is ready to go. The last kind of review task I wanted to talk about is proofreading. Even though many clients, including translation agencies, could ask you to proofread something that was translated or originally written by someone else, proofreading is actually the act of proofing a final copy of a document. In other words, you work with a proof, which is the text, supposedly already reviewed and copy edited, that is inserted in the final format you will be consumed in. So, for example, you may be hired to proofread a website, a slide presentation, or a PDF that will become a brochure, a book, a magazine, or newspaper. This kind of reviewing project may include copy editing, in case that step wasn't covered by someone else. But in other words, you won't overlook typos and mistakes just because you're supposed to look for other things when proofreading a document. Well, what you'll definitely be doing when reading a proof is looking for page formatting. Is everything shown correctly on the page? Was part of the text cut off by any chance? What I mean is, when I translate from English to Portuguese, for example, my translation tends to have more characters, more words than the original, and that's just the nature of the language. So sometimes the person in charge of putting the document together ends up overlooking that fact, and when copying and pasting my translation to a text box, they may forget to increase the size of that text box, and then the end of my translation is never shown on the page. Another thing you must be careful with when proofreading a document is syllable separation, especially if you're working with a language other than English. The software commonly used for desktop publishing, that is, programs that create pages for publication, usually only have syllable separation rules for English. So if I'm working with the text in Portuguese, I need to spot syllables that have been separated incorrectly and indicate that for the client to correct. Other times, special characters such as accented letters, for example, are not reproduced correctly, so you need to pay attention to that as well. So these are the kind of editing tasks that you may perform to diversify your portfolio, to keep different projects coming your way, to keep your workflow, to keep yourself busy, so you don't have to depend specifically on the translation projects they already do.